I have been waiting for months to finally open this box. I'm a bit nervous. Is that weird? This box is huge. And inside, well, let's take a look. But first, let me take you back to where this all began. On the 26th of February, 2021, I posted a video announcing my goal to reach 100,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel by the end of the year. Wait, what's today's date? No way. That was basically exactly a year ago. Oh, we should have published this video on Saturday and it would have been like perfect. Anyway, I only had 15,500 subscribers at the time. So it was a pretty ambitious goal, but if you know me, I tend to be a pretty ambitious person. But I wanted to make this goal fun and bring you along on the journey, so I decided to give away a huge set of 120 polychromos in a wooden case to someone else when I reach that goal. And also to treat myself with the same set as a reward to look forward to. Long story short, we had an amazing year, but we didn't make the goal. And I have a whole video talking about how that felt here. But we decided to extend the giveaway, and today our day has finally come. This week, we finally passed the huge goal of 100,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel. And I want to extend a huge thank you to every single one of you who has supported my channel and helped me get here. I will be announcing the winner of the giveaway later in this video, but for now, I've got my own set here and I am just as eager as you are to take a look inside. So no more talking, let's open it up. I wonder if this is like a typical Amazon thing where it's like, the box is huge, but the product's like tiny. Our boxes now use less material, but there's a box inside a box. I'm gonna do a Nerdy Crafter tribute here. This one's for you, Jackie. No, that didn't work. Try it again. Chai, please don't include that one in the video. This one's for you, Jackie. I suck at this. Ah, oh, this takes more skill than it looks. Oh, can we magically make the box underneath disappear? This looks a little bit more of a realistic size for the pencils I was expecting. Ooh, here we go. Sorry, Shane. It's getting real now.
It's getting a lot smaller too.
It's shrinking very quickly. I don't even know what to do next. What do I do? I feel like I just need to like just sit here for a moment and just admire this and just, wow. Okay, before I pull this amazing sleeve off, we have, it's heavy, all of our colors in the back. That giant sleeve, how's that for a pencil sleeve? But here is the main event. This thing is massive. It's actually a lot bigger than I was expecting. I was expecting it to be more like the size of my Luminance pencils. So for comparison, here is my Caran d'Ache pencil box. Look at how much bigger that is. That is huge. All right, let's do this. No way. When I first saw the option to buy these pencils with the extra box, I didn't realize just how nice it was. The box adds about an extra $100 to the price, so I thought it was an expensive gimmick and was only treating myself because this was a celebration of such a big milestone. But now that it's here, I can see that this box is definitely high quality and justifies the price. It makes the pencils so accessible and presents them beautifully, which is definitely a great way to get your creative ideas flowing. And no, this isn't a sponsored video. I'm just really excited. I've been waiting to open this for a year. Just make sure you keep it on a flat surface to avoid injury. Let's check out these colors. One of the things I hear people rave about these pencils the most is their well thought out color range. There are 120 colors total with a great mix of colors and some really vibrant hues. I know some people find the process of swatching to be tiring, but honestly, when the pencils are as nice as these, it's kind of fun. I always use it as a chance to practice my shading and even coloring, and to catch up on some of my favorite YouTubers on my phone or my iPad while I'm swatching. Watching and swatching. I like to color my swatches with more pressure on the left and less on the right so I can see the different layers of color each pencil can create. And in a moment, you'll see how I cut these into strips to make them even more useful for matching colors. This printable, by the way, will be available soon on my website as a part of a larger bundle of swatches and charts that I'm currently working on. I've been talking about it for a while and it's almost ready. The best way to find out when it comes out is to jump on my email list where I send out weekly updates about new videos, freebies and products, so you'll always be the first to know. There's a link in the description to sign up for free. With the swatching done, you'll notice that most of these pencil colors are almost a perfect match for the colors of the barrels. This is a feature that you only get with quality pencils and is so helpful if you're wanting to skip the swatching and just grab a color as you go. I have a few videos on my channel where I talk through how to blend colored pencils to create beautiful gradients like these. And each time I've used Prismacolor pencils, which have a wax base. So I've often been asked to show how this process works with oil-based pencils like the Faber-Castell Polychromos. I actually did an example of blending with the Polychromos pencils a while ago, but it was later on in one of my earlier videos, so you might have missed it. So let's do it again. I've chosen the same paper that I used on these Prismacolor gradients, and I want to use similar colors to either this first or this last gradient so we can get a closer comparison with the end result. The actual blending process is the same, and it does take practice to get a really smooth result, but you can do it with any pencils. Keep your pencils sharp and your layers light. Aim for at least 3 to 4 layers of color, but add more layers if you need. There's no perfect amount of layers here. As you use each color, make sure it overlaps with the color next to it, slowly using less pressure on each side. The more it overlaps and fades into the next color, the smoother it will look in the end result. I've done a short video on my channel showing the difference between blending with overlapping colors and without overlapping colors, and it's even more important with oil pencils because they are not as forgiving as the wax-based pencils. The key to doing this well with the oil-based pencils is to give more attention to your lower layers and not rely as heavily on your top layer to magically fix everything like it might be able to do with a more blendable pencil like the Prismacolor. There are other blending tools that you can use to help with this process, which I'll talk about shortly, but for this example, I wanted to show that it is possible to achieve this effect with pencils alone. So if the Prismacolors are easier to blend, what's so special about these pencils? The Faber-Castell Polychromos are the go-to pencils for many professional artists. They are one of the highest quality pencils you can buy. They have a high light fuss rating, meaning the colors last over many years, making them a great choice for professional artists. They have a very strong core and they are easy to keep sharp, so they are perfect for fine details. Oil-based pencils do take a bit more skill and practice to blend and layer than wax-based pencils, but they have a very strong core and are easy to keep sharp. So they are perfect for fine details, which is something that most pencils advertised as blendable lack. Many artists choose to use Polychromos pencils alongside another brand like Prismacolor or Caran d'Ache Luminance to get the best of both the blending and the fine details. In fact, this is how I will probably be using them the most. By the way, if you're interested in learning more pencil techniques like this, make sure you subscribe. Even when I'm just having fun or taking on an art challenge, I always love to slip in little tutorials or find ways to teach you tricks that can help you to become more creative. The color intensity of this is just wow. And when I compare this to my Prismacolor page, I've noticed something that I didn't see earlier. My Prismacolor artwork actually has wax bloom, which is where a cloudy film develops over time on wax-based pencils. You can just wipe this off with a tissue when it happens, but this is one thing that won't happen when you're using oil-based pencils. So So about our different blending options. I covered these in more detail in a video a few months ago, but here is a quick look at the results after some time has passed. The first swatch here is the same as the method that we've used, and these blender pencils are a great simple option if you need to remove extra white grain in your paper or smooth out your colors just a little bit more. I was really surprised to see that on all my samples, the baby oil has actually now left a stain. Even though I see this recommended all the time. The alcohol marker and the solvents all worked really well, but not the Zest pencil blend. Although to clarify, I don't think this was actually the Zest-It pencil blend that I added to my cart at the time. But it didn't just ruin these swatches, it also ruined my 50K Crayola artwork and has left these horrible yellow stains over everything. But if you want to see more about these blending tools, I'll link to the full video below so that you can see them in more detail. I've also tested the Polychromos in the past as a part of my paper recommendations video, and I still have those swatches because I keep everything. Your paper choice comes a lot down to preference, and I go through this in far more detail in the paper video, but for these Polychromos pencils specifically, I didn't really like any of the smooth papers, even the high quality smooth Bristol. Instead, I prefer something with a bit of texture to allow for more layering, since that's where these pencils perform the best. My favorites are probably the hot pressed watercolor paper and the Bristol vellum, especially the 100% cotton paper, although that is pretty expensive. And they do work on black paper too, although I haven't really tried a full colored pencil drawing on black paper to push any of these brands to their limit. But all this testing wasn't just for nothing. I wanted to prepare myself for a special piece of original art with these pencils. I wanted to create something special with these to celebrate reaching 100,000 subscribers, but I also didn't feel I could possibly do it justice in the short time frame that we had to put this video together this week. So I'm going to spend the next 2 weeks working on what will probably be my biggest colored pencil drawing ever, and I need your input. I want to create an art piece with 100 different items that represent the videos and the journey of the first 100,000 subscribers of this channel. So please tell me in the comments what reminds you of this channel and what you think should be included in the art piece. I've already made a start on a basic sketch, but I've left plenty of room for all your ideas. And in 2 weeks' time, I will show you the full process and the final piece that I create with the Polychromos pencils. Make sure you're subscribed with your notifications on so that you don't miss that video. And to finish up, the announcement we've all been waiting months for. A huge congratulations to our winner of the 120 Faber-Castell Polychromos pencils in a beautiful box to match mine here, Karina Macias-Franco. I hope you treasure these pencils as much as I know that I will. And thank you so much to everyone else who participated. This is just the beginning of our art journey, and I'm glad that you're coming along for the ride.